आई थिंक द बैलेंस इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. एवरीथिंग इज़ अबाउट द राइट बैलेंस. सो द बैलेंस बिटवीन स्पेंडिंग एंड सेविंग, द बैलेंस बिटवीन वर्किंग एंड स्पेंडिंग फैमिली टाइम, द बैलेंस बिटवीन यू नो बिटवीन अ कैपिटलिस्ट एंड अ सोशलिस्ट बेंट ऑफ माइंड. सो ऑल दैट इज द बैलेंस इज बेसिकली द की. सो मनी इज़ अबाउट लाइक यू नो अफोर्डिंग एक्सपीरियंसिस, अबाउट अफोर्डिंग क्वालिटी टाइम, हॉलीडेज विथ योर फैमिली. सो इट इज़ इम्पॉर्टेंट, बट एट द सेम टाइम इफ यू हैव अ लॉट ऑफ मनी एंड यू डोंट हैव एनी टाइम एंड यू डोंट हैव हेल्थ, देन इट्स यू नो इट्स पॉइंटलेस एज वेल. माई हस्बैंड इज़ ऑल्सो एग्जैक्टली लाइक माई डैड. ही इज़ ऑल्सो वेरी वेरी पर्टिक्युलर अबाउट सेविंग एंड वेरी पर्टिक्युलर अबाउट not spending excessively and rashly, you know, and maintaining a constant standard of living irrespective of your income. That is something we've always strived to do. Whether your income is X or Y, your standard of living should be constant, so that, you know, there's no stress. And I feel money should not give you stress. Money should be just considered to be a means to an end, and it should not constantly kind of, you know, worry you. Nowadays, I find like the younger generation, they're worried about money. They're worried if, you know, things don't go right for them for a bit, if there's no job, there's a little bit of a, you know, a redundancy or something, they can't take it because of their needs. And youngsters should learn to save right from the time they start working. Saving is a very important part of, you know, because if you don't save, how are you going to plan for a contingency? And contingencies, I think, are, you know, the law of averages says that your everything can't go well for you all the time. So where there's an up, there will always be a down, whether it's in business or in health or in anything for that matter. So I feel that saving is something that should be really inculcated in youngsters. I think money is actually quite simple, honestly, but we complicate it and we give it too much of importance and much more than required, honestly. I feel it's simple. It's you can keep your life quite stress-free if you have the right kind of values, if you have the right kind of spending habits, if you have the right attitude towards money, your life can be simple. If you are erratic and unplanned and reckless and rash and greedy, then you can make your life complicated. We try and maintain regular savings. So I enjoy, right now I've been investing in systematic investment plans, which kind of, you know, enable you to save every month a fixed amount from your earning into these various diversified mutual funds. So you invest a little in mutual funds, a little bit in shares, a little bit in your fixed deposits, a little bit in property and in life insurance company. At the same time, you know, see to it that your factory premises and your home are fully insured by a strong fire insurance policy. So that way, medical insurance is also a very important factor, because today the rising costs of medical bills are quite scary, and one huge illness can just wipe out. So you don't want to fall ill, or you don't want anyone to fall ill, but you know that that is one area that you need to cover too. Emergencies and problems and contingencies don't inform us when they come, they just come. And if we don't provide for those times in good times, then we definitely lack planning and foresight. So I think, yeah, anyone with foresight, anyone with planning, anyone with a sense of, a sense of right and wrong would definitely take insurances for sure. I think it's very short-sighted if anyone thinks that they are not required. The most important thing money can buy is good sleep at night. So it gives us that sense of, you know, security and being at ease with ourselves. So why would anyone not do that for anything in the world? Honestly, as a human being, what exactly like are our needs? Like, we don't really, really, really need many of the things that we aspire to own, you know. So keeping your needs simple, like emphasizing on other pleasures in life and other things in life, like hobbies and, you know, family and things like intangibles, basically. I feel everything doesn't have to be like a tangible thing to keep you happy. Like, you don't have to own a big car to be happy, but you can be happy with just, you know, maybe pursuing a hobby or something. So, you know, keeping yourself free from too many desires, I feel, keeps you happy, honestly.